now. I am going to take a sip of my coffee before I head out. This video will probably be uploaded today. I think I've already spoken to this. What is this supposed to be? A parakeet? A parrot? Some sort of rooster? I don't know, but it's some sort of bird I can speak to. Anyways, I'm having my final cup of coffee before I head out. I'll probably be uploading this after I come home. I got a package in the mail today. In fact, I did a box unopening of it, but it is not the package that I was anticipating. Which makes me wonder if I am ever going to get it. I sent my Zippo in for repair. I don't even know how many weeks ago. I know it was last month, but last month was 3 days ago, so I want to say 2 weeks. And I know I sent it incorrectly. I had my address on it. The return address on the envelope plus the return address inside the parcel, you know, where to send the Zippo once it's repaired. And yet, I have still not gotten my Zippo back, and I'm getting more as a little impatient. I'm thinking I might just say, you know what? Fuck this shit and get another Zippo pipe wire. Because I do have big lighters. But when I'm out and about and want to smoke my pipe, I don't trust Bic, because Bic's not exactly windproof, where Zippo is. No, Zippo's not 100% windproof, obviously, but it's windproof enough. Like, I can light my Zippo, or my pipe lighter. I can light my pipe on a windy day using my Zippo. Using a Bic, not so much. I was going to wait for that bird to fly by, but here it comes. And looks like I can't speak to it anyways. I think I already spoke to that guy, I don't know. But anyways, yeah. I don't want to buy a new Zippo if there was a reason that, you know, I already have a Zippo pipe layer. I needed it sent in for repairs. As far as how far away I sent it in for repairs, I mean, it'd be a less than an hour and a half drive, give or take anyways. I live in Hamilton, I sent it into Niagara. Zebra is not that far from where I live. In fact, it's not that far at all. So why it hasn't come back yet, I don't know. Now bear in mind, I have not checked my mail today. So maybe it came in today, I don't know. What I do know is my mail lady tends to overall be very inconsistent of when she comes to deliver our mail. But generally speaking, it tends to be very late in the evening when the mail is delivered. It is past 4 o'clock, 4 in the afternoon. And lately I've been, well, I'm going to use this way. I've been checking the mail past 6 in the afternoon, 16. And the mail has not come in yet, but when I checked later on in what will be considered the late evening or early evening, late, early night sort of time, the mail will be in. So, yeah, our postwoman can be a little inconsistent, but she is a good postwoman overall anyways. Say I have a package. Oh, I can find this. But say I have a package that's too big to fit the mailbox, but there's it has my phone number on the address. Well, she will phone me and say, by the way, do you mind, if you're home, do you mind stepping out front? I have a package here for you. And I thoroughly appreciate that. I live in an apartment. It is not always, I shouldn't even say it is not always, it is pretty much never practical for the postwoman to deliver the package straight to the front door of my apartment, because she has no key to get to the apartment. Now, sometimes it does happen, but I can't say for certain how those circumstances arise where she's able to deliver it right to my door. But I am guessing it's because I don't think I can get up that way. I am guessing it's because I go downstairs if I care. I am guessing it's because someone saw her delivering mail and opened the door to get into the building. Because we have a front door, which is, for lack of a better term, the outside door, which leads into the entrance where the mailboxes are. Then we have a second door, which leads into the building, but that door requires a key. So her getting into the building where the apartments are, she doesn't have a key for it. So I never expect my package to be delivered. Excuse me. Straight to my door. But I do appreciate it when she phones me and says there's a package, do you mind coming out to get it? What she does do, providing there is a phone number on the package, that's for my Zippo there will not be. The package that arrived, well, technically it arrived yesterday, and I was a bit confused why I got a postal note to pick it up and not have it delivered into my actual mailbox, because I was fully expecting it to be my Zippo. Now, I was expecting a package from Amazon, and the package I was expecting, I would have thought, would have been able to fit into my mailbox. Now, it was the Amazon package. And in regards to the box it was delivered in, there was no way it would have been able to fit inside my mailbox. That is more, I don't know whose fault it will be, but considering it was an Amazon package, I will blame that more on Amazon or what have you than anyone else, because the box was simply way too large considering how small the item was. As I said, I did a very bad box opening for it, but the box was big. The package, not so much. It was a bottle of Stetson, a bottle of cologne. And it came in a box that it simply has no business being that big, considering it was literally a single vial of cologne. So, why the hell it was like that, I don't know, but, well. I mean, at least they didn't use packing peanuts or plastic to sort of keep the actual package from bumping around or what have you, but the box was just simply way too big, considering it. The package could have easily fit inside the mailbox if it were packaged correctly. And yes, I do sometimes use cologne. I'm gonna save my game even though I use save space. But anyway, the box is just simply way too big considering how small the item was. It had no business. Birds. I'm guessing this is armor. Is it armor? I'm also guessing that because it's armor, I could have found it later on if I were to simply go to a dungeon, but... Considering how I usually play these games in a... Well, I should say that considering I usually play RPGs in general in a sort of grindy fashion, I'm just simply going to buy it and deal with it that way. I have no idea what it is I am supposed to do. And I've been recording for almost 17 minutes. And you have... Well, I guess I guess I have not made any progress. Is this the same area that I just climbed up on? Yes it is. Yes it is. Yes it is. Anyways, I'm thinking there's some major head honcho. To keep mentioning this king bird. Is this the dungeon that I just came from? Yes. So I'm guessing that whatever it is, I need to either go here. I was going to say Zera, but that's just the... That's just part of the mountain on a trail I can follow. Excuse me, but that's a bit of good. Me again. Not only did I just finish my coffee, but I had some food as well, so I am a little gassy. My nose is also a little stuffed though. I've been using between aniseed extra and extra tons of comfort nasal stuff in regards to my nose being stuffed, and it works. I mildly regret mixing the two because the extra tons of comfort will probably work better on my own or on its own. In regards to my stuffed up nose. But alas, you know. It's working overall in just in regards to, for lack of a better term. Filling my nostril, or declogging my nostrils. I feel like I need to speak to this guy. How do I get to that guy? Assuming I get to that guy. Oh. worst-case scenario, I'll just look up a guide or what have you with sheep. But considering I haven't even really been playing the game that much, I mean, look at me, I'm just sort of in a plot significant area where there's no real gameplay to be had. I don't feel it necessary to look up a guide. They keep mentioning the highest point. Now, did I scare you? I tell you this much. You're, scary looking for all the wrong reasons kind of bird. I mean, you're not exactly scary looking in that I'm worried you're going to attack me. I feel a sneeze coming on one moment. Okay, maybe not. So he's more scary in the... I'm worried he's contagious. He's going to constantly ask me for a favor. Kinda scary. Not going to harm me by attacking scary more. He's going to be more parasitic, kinda scary. And it looks like he is asking me for a favor, but then again, considering this is an action-adventure role-playing game, that's to be expected. So alas, it looks like I have to go to Windvale. And I don't know where Windvale is, except that it's supposed to be a cavern nearby. Yes, there is. Okay. There's our thing. Anyways, it looks like there's a cavern nearby. Whether or not the cavern is nearby outside on the world map, or nearby as in... Wait a minute. There's a cavern. There's a cavern right there. But alas, whether you see caverns outside of the world map or located in that particular area, I don't know, but I've been recording for almost 25 minutes. I'm ending it now. Take care, everybody, and bye.